Just got back from my gigs this weekend in Germany, and I'm here at my studio in Miami, Florida. I'm gonna take you guys inside. We're gonna check out the studio and the new video for Let Loose. Let's go. When I was making Let Loose, I really wanted to make like a party record, you know, something that people were really, you know, when they hear it, they just really feel what the song is saying, and they wanna get on the dance floor, they wanna party, they wanna be with their friends. And I wanted to kind of bridge this gap between nightclubs and radio, and something you can hear over the radio as well. You know, as well in the club as in the club. I wanted it to, you know, go across all these platforms. And I wanted a lot of people to really feel this song. There's a lot of different ways that I work in the studio. Like sometimes I'll have already a bit of the vocal and I'll start building the track around it. Sometimes I'll have an idea for a track and I'll get into the studio and start really banging out a new track, and I'll send it off to whichever vocalist I'm working with. In the case of Let Loose, I had a bit of the vocal and I started you know, just really building up the vibe of the song to it. And we finished it off, and everything just came out really right on it. The track and the vocal really fit together really well, and it really captured that you know, that party vibe that we were going for with the record. Yeah, sometimes when I'm touring, I'll be gone and playing like every day for like 2-3 weeks or whatever. And you know, as soon as I land back here in Miami, I gotta get straight into the studio. And to be honest, sometimes I really, you know, I don't have that drive to create music because I'm just so tired. But, you know, I might relax for a day when I get back. But, you know, usually after I take that day to relax, I get in the second day. And, you know, once I turn the music on and I start getting into it, it all comes back. And I forget about how tired I am and how much I've been traveling. And it all comes back, and I get back into the vibe and I'm feeling it again. And it kind of all comes back. A lot of times in interviews, people ask me, you know, first, you know, is my passion, or am I a DJ first or a producer first? And, you know, I always answer the question that, you know, I'm both. Now, I did start DJing before I started producing, but now it kind of works in a circle. It's like I DJ to get ideas for records, and then I go into the studio and make the record, and then I take them back out on tour to DJ with. So it's this circle that keeps, you know, keeps going around, that, you know, keeps this whole thing going. And that's why I always say, you know, I am a producer and I'm a DJ, and the two feed each other. Let's go check out the video. Wanna get physical, can't even try to deny it, wanna scream and shout. I feel so handcuffed. I can't be tamed, wanna let loose out on the floor. Break out my cage, my body's ready to explore. Get out my way if you're not. When we were thinking about a video for this song, Let Loose, it's like we really wanted to capture in the video the feeling of the song, and like this party spirit, and like really having fun and letting loose. And we threw a lot of ideas around, and we kept coming back to the one idea that everybody was like, yeah, that's what we need to do, a house party, like a basement party, or in somebody's garage or their basement in their parents' house or something. You know, we all started thinking back to when we were in high school and the kind of parties we had, what people were doing, and we just threw all these ideas together, and we came up with this really cool concept to do this like raging house party. All kinds of crazy stuff was going on, and the thing was, it was like, it was a real party. I mean, we had real drinks and people were really like letting loose. It wasn't like it was set up. We were just like having a good time. I mean, we had like this rabbit head, we had people jumping on trampolines. You know, at the end of the video, like somebody thought it'd be a good idea to write on my forehead. That wasn't even in the plan, but it happened, you know. So it was just a crazy video. We had a lot of fun. We were really having fun, and I think it really came through on the video. People see that we're really, you know, letting loose. Mandy Ventrice, you know, our vocalist for this song, we thought, yeah, we wanted to do some shots, some cutaways from the party, you know, to put her in different environments. And somebody had this idea, the guys from Vid-Atlantic, the guys who produced the video, they're like, yeah, let's put her on this, like this plexiglass up in the air, like she's just floating. And I was like, oh, okay, yeah, cool, that might look good. And they built this, you know, this big platform, and she's up on this glass, like 8 feet in the air, and just kind of floating up there, and it looked awesome. It cut in the video really well. I was really happy with it. They did a great job. Well, this one, like, you know, we had like a cast and a crew, but also I was like, look, if we're gonna do this, I really gotta get some of my friends, my real friends in there, so we can really have a party. So like I you know, I called up my good friends that, you know, back in school and got them to come up, and they were the ones who really set the party off because I knew they would. And we just had a great time, and it was just, it was a really good, you know, natural feeling. Like I said, we had a lot of fun. Of course, we did some shots where it was set up with the song, but as well, like a lot of the extra footage we got and a lot of the B-roll stuff is like me, like really DJing, and we really had a party. I mean, people were having a great time. Mandy, the singer, we was having a great time. We were just really, we just threw down, we had a party. A lot of the people didn't know each other, but you know, by the end of this video shoot, everybody was like just talking and just having a great time. It was like, you know, as well as a good video, it was one of the best parties I've ever been at. Yeah, usually, you know, like when we're working on new tracks or we're writing or whatever, a lot of times we'll write it, the song, to, you know, a track that we're not even gonna use in the end. And by the time the production is done, it sounds nothing like the first version. So usually after we're done writing the song to like a beginning kind of track, I just throw that all out and I have the vocal there by itself and I just start building around it. I think that when you build the music around the vocal, it just really kind of sits really well and it all works together, like, you know, really well together. So, you know, I'll have the vocal there. I'll usually start with just some drums or something. And then usually the first element I add is the bass line, because the bass and the drums working together is like the foundation of dance music, and that's the most important part. And then you just start adding like the little embellishments, the chords, the little tricks here and there, noises, synths. But again, like the foundation is that kick drum and the bass that really drives dance music. I think it's a really exciting time for dance music right now, because like the American R&B, urban, and pop industry is starting to really embrace what we've been doing. You know, we've been doing it for years, but now it's like hitting America again. And a lot of the big artists are coming to get like, you know, more of a dance sound. And it's really looking good for our genre right now. Like, I spend a lot of time between here, the States, and the, you know, Miami area and Europe. And it's really efficient to have a studio in both places. I can go back and forth. And I've been spending a lot more time here in the US. Of course, I'm from the US. But I'm spending a lot more time back here. A lot because the dancing is really starting to take off again here. I'm starting to play more in the States and tour more here. And yeah, it's really convenient to have like the two places, Europe and the US, bouncing back and forth between the two. When I'm in the studio and making music, it's like, you know, I'm always thinking about the people, you know, my fans and the people who listen to the music, the people on the dance floor. I know there's other artists and producers out there that kind of make their music for the critics or for the press or whatever. But, you know, when I'm making my music, I'm thinking about my fans. I'm thinking about the people on the dance floor, how they'll react and how they're going to, you know, like, you know, what they're going to go for in the music. And that's my first, you know, concern when I'm making music. You know, the single we're talking about right now is Let Loose, but that's gonna be one of the singles off the album that I'm working on right now in the studio. I've got a lot of different features. I'm working with a lot of different artists, some that I've worked with before and a lot of new artists too that I've never worked with. I've got some really big names on the album as well, some big name features, some big American artists. I can't really mention them yet, but you're gonna see it on the album. It's been a lot of fun, and I'm wrapping it up in the studio right now. It's gonna be out soon. So this is the studio. This is where I spend all my time. This is where it happens. I spend a lot of time working really hard in here, but I also like to have fun in here too. There's been a lot of crazy nights in this studio.